Hi again, everyone. Mike Conrad here, founder of Aqueous Technologies and host of the Reliability Matters podcast with you once again for more tips and tricks for cleaning circuit assemblies. If you've been in the electronic assembly industry for virtually any amount of time, there's little doubt you've heard of the term ECM, electrochemical migration. What causes ECM and what type of failures does it produce? I'll answer those questions when I return in just a moment. ECM is the process of laying conductive materials over insulating materials, resulting in a reduction of resistivity or electrical shorts. Electrochemical migration, or ECM, is the dissolution and movement of metal ions in the presence of an electric potential, which results in the growth of dendritic structures between the anode and the cathode. The process is most commonly observed in printed circuit boards, where it may significantly decrease the insulation between conductors. The main factor facilitating ECM is humidity. Usually the process involves several stages: water absorption, anode metal dissolution, ion accumulation, ion migration to the cathode, and dendritic growth. Once the dendrite grows between the anode and the cathode, the resistance between the anode and the cathode drops to almost zero, creating an electrical short. Sometimes there's not enough dissolution of the metals to create a dead short, but could still result in a reduction of electrical resistance. If a circuit assembly is not cleaned and conductive residues are allowed to remain on the assembly, a common phenomenon when the boards are reflowed using no clean flux and not subjected to a cleaning process is the ionic residues may become problematic under specific circumstances. As I explained, it takes three factors to create an ECM event. First, the assembly must have an electrical bias. All circuit assemblies have an electrical bias. Second, there must be a conductive residue on the assembly. Conductive residues can be found in board fabrication residues, component fabrication residues, human residues, and assembly residues, including flux. There must be moisture. Where does the moisture come from? The most common form of moisture is humidity. Electrochemical migration failure mechanisms fall into three categories: dendritic growth, parasitic electrical leakage, and conductive anodic filamentation, or CAF. The most common and most severe manifestation of ECM is dendritic growth. Here you can see three images of assemblies with dendritic growth. The metal structure growing between the anode and the cathode is conductive. The second form of ECM is parasitic electrical leakage. Parasitic leakage is not visible. It lacks the metal structure found in dendritic growth. While parasitic leakage does not normally lead to a dead short, it does reduce the dielectric properties of the laminate, allowing some current to flow between the anode and the cathode. This could result in rapid battery drain or situations which cause the assembly to malfunction. The third form of ECM is conductive anodic filamentation, or CAF. I like to refer to CAF as a subterranean ECM event, as it occurs not on the surface of the assembly, but between the layers of the assembly. While surface level ECM requires three elements: electrical bias, conductive residues, and moisture, a fourth element is required for CAF. There must be a pathway. On the surface of the assembly, the entire surface is a pathway. Between the layers of the board, pathways are normally created during the board fabrication process. Pathways may be created when the glass resins in the board material become separated, frequently referred to as dry weave. Pathways may also be created during the drilling process. Through holes and vias are drilled into the board. If the drills are dull or if excessive pressure is used in the drilling process, it may open up pathways. With CAF, the conductive residues come from the plating solutions used to plate the through holes and the vias. While surface-level ECM can be prevented by performing a thorough cleaning process, CAF cannot be prevented by cleaning. CAF can be prevented by either preventing the pathways from forming or by performing a thorough bakeout process to remove any moisture between the layers of the board. However, even if a thorough bakeout is performed, moisture can penetrate through the layers of the board over time, especially if the assembly is located in a harsh environment. For complete and permanent CAF elimination, it's best to ensure there are no pathways for the electrical bias, conductive residues, and moisture to exploit. If CAF is a concern, select board materials that are CAF resistant. So to wrap up, to prevent ECM from occurring on the surface of the assembly, subject the assemblies to a thorough cleaning process. To prevent CAF, select CAF-resistant board materials, which reduce the possibility of gaps between the layers. I hope you found this topic helpful. Keep your questions and topic suggestions coming. Send them right over here to my email address, and be sure and listen to or watch the Reliability Matters podcast. Check it out on Apple Podcasts, Google Podcasts, Spotify, Amazon Music, or virtually wherever you get your podcasts. Or watch the podcast on the Reliability Matters YouTube channel. Just go on YouTube and search for Reliability Matters. And be sure to subscribe and hit the bell icon to receive new episode notifications. Also, if you're interested in taking a deep dive into cleaning and cleanliness quantification best practices, sign up for my Cleaning and Cleanliness Quantification Masterclass. There's more than 5.5 hours of on-demand video content and more than 500 pages of downloadable course content, all for $99. More information is available on our website. The link is right over there. Thanks for watching. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy, and perhaps most importantly, keep doing it right. I'll see you again very soon.